What's up, guys? It's Bishop here with Michael Niehaus. Just woke him up from a nap. So 1:30 in the morning on 10/26/09 with some breaking news in the sports world. You know, this is a exclusive episode of Niehaus Knows Sports, you would say. Big issue going on. I'm going to let Michael take it away. He's more familiar with the material than I am. So take it away, Mike.
Okay, as you sports fans will know, and, you know, me being in the sports broadcasting with my Niehaus.
I would say you're familiar with sports.
Being in the sports media, so to speak.
Not actually in there. Episodes aren't online anymore, so you're actually not in the broadcasting.
Anyways, you're familiar with sports. A colleague of mine, Jim Nance.
Didn't really go to your college.
No, a colleague.
What do you mean?
Colleagues are people that, you know, for example, you like videotaping. Bob McCoy would be a colleague. You work together. You're in the same industry.
But you're not in that industry is what I'm saying.
Okay, well, okay. So anyways, Jimmy Nance, famous CBS play-by-play announcer, that's Final Four, Masters, NFL.
Great Final Four announcer.
Oh, fantastic. Remember he did with Billy Packer?
Absolutely.
Maddie's best friend.
Yeah, right.
Maddie.
UK Billy Packer, UK.
So anyways, John Wall. Jimmy Nance, just comes down, 26 years married to his wife, and now finds out that he's a 29-year-old girlfriend, and it's causing a big...
Hold on, he finds out he has a 29... What do you mean? You just said he finds out he has a 29-year-old girlfriend.
No, us in the media.
The media, okay, so they bring in the words. Okay.
I said, I probably being, you know, a colleague of Jim working in the same industry, found out a little earlier, but now the whole media knows.
Right.
That, and I just had a divorce court on Thursday or Friday, and just big breaking news, because he was known as the one guy in sports broadcasting that this all-American guy, nice as can be to the fans. He was what you got when you watched him on TV, married, had a kid, and now this comes out. And he said his marriage was dead 10 years ago, but...
People can say that, though. As an excuse for
I just think it's a big story, and I'm upset for Jimmy.
Why? Explain
why. A lot of respect for him. Was at the 2001 Final Four when Duke Blue Devils. I know Ben Chapman. You know Ben Chapman.
Yeah,
big fan of Duke, so he wasn't there, but I've told him about my Final Four experience.
So he's irrelevant in this case.
Anyways, Jimmy, after the game, he signed a seat cushion for me. His famous saying, a tradition unlike any other, the Masters on CBS, and gave me a media guide of the Arizona Wildcats. And ever since then, I've had a lot of respect for how kind he was.
So have you lost respect for him?
Absolutely. I'm disappointed.
Let's be choice on those words. Okay, you're disappointed in him, but the
pointed in how the whole situation went down.
Okay, I agree with that. And you know what? We really can't comment on their situations because we're not in them. Yes,
right.
We face temptations
throughout
each day.
You know, as our colleagues in the media report on it, but we don't...
Not our colleagues, but people that we see in the media who report on it, they get probably faced with more temptation than we do because they're surrounded by it. So we can't say, oh, they shouldn't have done that. They could have control. We really can't talk for them, but we are disappointed for his situation. Our prayers go out to the family. Hopefully his heart heals. Let God fill that hole in his heart.
Jesus,
he's
actually Jewish.
Oh, is he? Okay.
So, and there's nothing wrong with that. I just hope that he accepts Jesus as Lord and Savior.
Right, but yeah, there's nothing wrong. You got to respect all denominations of faith.
But the Bible does say that if you don't accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, they don't believe in the New Testament.
Right, and Jesus is the only way to heaven. But this is not... on a religious, let's not keep it...
Right. I'm just letting him know when you were talking about how his thoughts and our thoughts and prayers are with him.
Right, but we could still pray for someone who doesn't know the Lord Jesus
Christ.
That's
what I'm saying, is I hope through all this he'll accept Jesus.
Oh, okay, yeah, maybe... Oh, okay, I see he could turn to Jesus.
Exactly.
Kind of like Chris Rice says in Untitled Him, Come to Jesus. He can come to Jesus after the heartbreak he's going through. That's an excellent point. And maybe he will. Hopefully he does find happiness in that. So
right.
I think that's a good way to wrap up this guy. Or is there something else you want
to
say?
No, I just my thoughts and prayers go to Jimmy, his daughter, and his wife.
Oh, well, his ex-wife.
It's not official. The divorce.
Ooh. This is a curveball.
Coming this week is when it's going to be final.
Okay.
I don't think it's 100% legally final, but it's
going to be final four league. It was a joke off the final four.
Now's not the time to kid, but Niels does the sports, it's time to go.
No, stop. Why would you do that, Mike? Why would you do that? Nobody liked when you did that. In fact, it frustrated me. You knocked over your banana when you did that.
Oh, my gosh. That carpet got abused by me.
I know. Oh, man.